Kitten born with deformity gets totally unexpected transformation.
But before we start, please take a moment to give this video a like, subscribe, and hit the bell so you'll never miss these great stories.
When Pinocchio the kitty first arrived at Los Angeles' Friends for Life Rescue Network, founder Jacqueline Santiago knew that despite his good spirits, he had a number of health issues that needed immediate assistance. Doctors were eager to help him fully recover, but even they were caught off guard by this cat's unheard of transformation. For as long as Jacqueline de Amor Santiago could remember, she had a passion for anything that had to do with caring for animals. That was why she helped create one of Los Angeles' most popular animal rescue shelters. Friends for Life Rescue Network, FFLRN, worked around the clock nurturing animals who came through rough homes or were in need of medical assistance from accidents. The team behind Jacqueline was equally as dedicated. Everyone at the organization was a volunteer, and even though no one earned a living through their animal work, it was more important to know they were saving lives, especially when it came to a little kitty named Pinocchio. Even though Pinocchio came from a tumultuous household, he was all purrs when he arrived at the LA organization. He had a slew of health issues he needed taken care of, and it wasn't going to be easy. The most obvious? A misaligned jawbone that caused his mouth to look as if it had a sideways smirk, and that was just one issue. He was no Garfield, and looked as though Pinocchio hadn't eaten a proper meal in days. Upon arriving, workers gave him two full cans of food that he devoured right before nestling up in a cozy bed and getting some much-needed rest. Over the course of a few days, it seemed like Pinocchio was gaining more strength by the minute. He was keeping active and his muscle mass was improving. Of course, he needed more than just strength, though. The medical team pointed out an issue in one of Pinocchio's pre-surgery scans. X-rays show his chest shape has completely changed over the last few weeks, the surgeon said, and this caused his breathing to suffer. He was also fighting off a rough upper respiratory infection and suffering from a painful umbilical hernia. These issues required more food than rest, so doctors got to work once he adjusted to life at FFLRN. The fact Pinocchio was only 3 months old meant extra delicate care was required with his little brittle body, but he was a trooper and he came out of the surgery with a new lease on life. After the operations were over, Jacqueline and the rest of the staff visited the little guy at the Animal Specialty and Emergency Center where the surgeries took place. He responded with an army of purrs as they admired his progress. Jacqueline said of Pinocchio after emerging from surgery, he completely won over the entire staff team taking care of him. They said he purred so loud they couldn't hear his heart, such a good boy. Pinocchio was eventually going to find a foster home for a permanent stay, but until that happened, Jacqueline brought him back to her place where he was greeted with a new bed and plush toy. Not only was the cat's breathing significantly smoother, but the flea issue was totally resolved too, and it seemed like he was excited about life again. This was the kind of change that everyone prayed for before. I came home yesterday to a very playful boy who wanted lots of scritches. He's been up and about and is feeling much better and getting more active every day, said Jacqueline. Of course, to show everyone just how far he came and how powerful he was feeling, Pinocchio donned a Superman shirt for the first several days. The guy really was like a tiny fluffy superhero. His spirit's just as it was, Jacqueline said. He's a strong, playful, loving sweetheart with the biggest purrs. When he sees me, he shoots out of the bed a little too fast and comes right over for pets. Pinocchio deserved a huge toast for his magical journey through the FFLRN network. He was once a lost little kitten in need of help, and now he was living like a VIP. As excited as Jacqueline was about Pinocchio's health, she was most happy for him to eventually mingle with other cats. Pinocchio's recovery was in large part due to the identifying of his unique condition early on. Jacqueline had been trying to spread awareness about health issues among cats to other shelters in her community. Fortunately, this paid off sooner rather than later when a random passerby spotted a litter of 5 kittens stranded in the rough and tumble streets of California in 2020. He knew they were in desperate need of a hero, and they were only 4 weeks old. He brought the quintet of kittens to San Jose's Mini Cat Town, which is dedicated to creating a safe haven for kittens in the Bay Area. The frightened cats were in good hands, but their problems weren't solved. With over 340 cats and kittens under its belt, Mini Cat Town has been rescuing felines since 2015. One of its volunteers, Sonia, vowed to be the kitten's foster mama, taking them into her care. Though all the fur babies were precious, it was Tina, a tabby with an adorably circular face who was the standout of the bunch. She was just a bit smaller than her siblings, so it was likely she was just the runt, right? Her first day at our place was full of exploration. Her shyness gave way to curiosity and a love for sitting on someone's lap in a matter of minutes, Sonia explained to Love Meow. She was the ultimate cuddle bug. As Sonia watched her rescued foster kittens grow, Tina still seemed different. Sonia had a strong gut feeling Tina wasn't simply the runt of the litter. She wasn't growing at the same speed as the other kittens, Marvin, Aretha, Deanna, and Nina. And Sonia wasn't the only one who noticed Tina's odd little physical quirks. She looks much different from the rest of her siblings, said Mini Cat Town co-founder Toa Bui. Her skull's wider and her bones are shorter and thicker. Not only that, but she wasn't putting on weight as fast as the rest of the litter. But little Tina wasn't gonna let her minuscule size stop her from enjoying the perks of kittenhood. Tina wrestled with her siblings and swatted at toys like nobody's business. It's almost as if she never noticed she was unique. She's extremely chill but also very curious. She always wants to know what the others are up to, explained Sonia. She also loves to play with toy balls and mice and can get pretty territorial over them, Sonia said. Just imagine little Tina getting territorial over a colorful feathered toy. Adorable! She's sweet and enjoys everyone's company. Her favorite thing to do is just hang out with whoever's nearby, Thoa said. Cuddled up next to her rapidly growing siblings, Tina still looked as though she was 4 weeks old. It was time for a vet checkup. Tina was poked and prodded by a specialist who then provided Sonia and Mini Cattown with her diagnosis. She has what's called chondrodystrophy, aka chondrodysplasia, which is a canine form of dwarfism, Thoa said. In other words, she was found like this and occurrences of these abnormalities are rare, Thoa said. Some signs of chondrodysplasia, which literally means abnormal growth of cartilage, are shortened limbs and flared metaphyses. And no, there's no treatment for this. Tina, however, is getting by. Though she's only a kitten, it's truly inspiring to see that nothing stops Tina from acting like a normal cat. Recently, she started to climb and jump on things more, which has opened up a whole new world for her to explore, Thoa said. Though Tina has a loaded agenda. Once she's done exploring, she's ideally nap in your lap for a few hours. If you're not available, a fluffy bed will have to do. What a spoiled little angel. And with this increased agility, Tina has discovered cozy new nooks and crannies. While climbing mountains of furniture, Tina discovered a little cubby in the TV console, perfect for cuddling into and hiding away, when she's in desperate need of some alone time. Tiny Tina's foster family aimed to give her as much mobility as possible, even building little steps for her. And while Tina may seem like a miniature version of a regular old cat now, that may change in the future. Though she is healthy now, kittens with this form of dwarfism may have complications with their health in the future, as malformations can exist undetected or form later in life. Tina's adoption process will be much different than that of her siblings. Adopting a special needs cat isn't for everyone, so her adoptive family will have to be extremely dedicated and empathetic. She'll need to be adopted to a family who can commit to lifelong special needs care should it arise, Thoa continued. Caring for a special needs animal, or any animal really, isn't something you can simply change your mind about later on. We just know that Tina and her adorable round face will have a kind, compassionate, patient forever family soon enough. Come on, who could resist that squishy face? And while Thoa, Mini Cattown co-founder and treasurer, has been an important piece to several rescue tales or tales, rescuing little Rosie was a bit more personal. It's sad to think a ball of fluff tiny enough to fit in a teacup left to fend for itself on the streets of San Jose, California. When sisters Thoa Thai and Trambui witnessed this exact reality in early 2016, they just had to step in. They immediately took the three-week-old kitten home where Thoa had experienced rescuing helpless creatures. The sisters told ABC News that by the time they rescued the stray kitten, she was malnourished, lethargic, and dying.